Today we're going to learn how to create your own menu with different inputs, like objects, text, materials, to switch between them really fast. By the way, I'm working with Blender 4.1. Let's delete the camera, the light, go to geometry nodes, let's close this and this panel. And let's create a new profile. And I want to delete this, and let's add, for example, a cube, and I want to add an icosphere. So imagine I want to switch between these two. You can do like that, just connect one and later disconnect this. But what if I want something to just have a menu and select A or B? We have a node for that. It's called menu switch. If you connect it here, this allows you to connect different data types, float, integer, vectors, strings, whatever you want. Now we are working with geometry because we want to change between geometries. So here I can connect in A this option and in B the icosphere. So here, if I click, I can switch really fast between A or B, between the cube or the icosphere. So I don't have to be disconnecting and connecting different wires. Maybe you're thinking, can you add more options? Of course. For example, let's add a cylinder. And to add more options, you have to select the node, press N to open the right menu, and go to node. And with this node selected, here you have the options. So if you click here, you can add more options, as many as you want, and here you can delete them. Or you can create and move them. If I want this one before, I just click here, as you can see. So now I can connect the cylinder in the third item, and you can change the name. Remember, select this, go here, and just double click and add your names. Cube, I'm going to delete this one, and this one. So really fast, I'm going to press N to hide this. We have a menu, a node, that allows us to change really fast between different options. If you want to change this from this panel, what you have to do is to bring group input, this one, the one that always we have, and here you can connect this. So it will appear here. So now from this panel, we can change the object. So you can do your own setup, and if you want to change between different objects, just create your own menu, and later you can change it here or here. Also, you can add other objects. You can create your own object and just add it here. For example, let's add a monkey. Let's hide it, come back to cube, and let's drag it here. So let's bring another item. And now let's connect it here. So now here I have another option to select the monkey. Another example is to use menu switch to add different materials. So first, let's select the material view. Let's add a set material node, so we can add materials to geometry nodes. Let's select a material, the default material. Let's change the color, for example, blue. And now I want a menu for materials. So what we can do is to bring here a menu switch. And if you do it like that, you have already material. If not, just create it and change and select material. So here we have different items and we can add different materials. In the first one, we are going to select the default material and let's create other materials. So let's go here, click on plus and create new materials. For example, red. And let's change the name, red, blue, and let's create two more, yellow and green. We have four materials, so here we can add as many materials as you want. Remember, if you want more items, select this, press N, go to node and add more items. So I'm going to add yellow and green. So now we can change really fast any material here. Remember, you can change these names, pressing N and going here. Now we can see here the names. And if you want to add it in this menu, like before, you can connect it directly here. Or what you can do if you want is just do a copy of that. Shift D and add it in a new socket. And here we have the colors. If you want to change this text, just select this, press N, and go to group, and here you can change the name. So this is the objects, remember? So let's change to objects, and this is colors. So let's bring colors or materials. So now here I can change really fast the object and change the color. Now I'm going to show you another node similar to this one, that it's called index switch. It's basically the same. The only difference is that this one, the way of selection, let me cut this, it's a menu. This is a menu, a drop down that we open and we select like this. However, this is the same. We have different options, but the way to select it is with an index, with numbers. So if it says 0, it's this one, but we can change to other numbers. So let me show it to you. Let's go into here. Let's select material because we need to use materials. Let's add blue, green. If you want to add more, remember, select this, press N, go to node, and here in the switch, let's add more items. Red, yellow. So if I want to change this, now I don't have a menu, I have an index. So 0 is the first one, and we can change with the index between the different items. And if you want it here, remember, connect it in a new socket, and we have it here like that. Another difference is that you cannot change the index for a name. Like before, here we can change all the names. Remember, if we select this, we can go here and change the name. However, if we select the index switch, we only have numbers. We don't have the option to click and change the name. So this is a negative thing. You need to click and switch between the index to see which option we are selecting. However, with this menu, we can see before clicking which option we are going to select. That's the main difference between menu switch and index switch. I'm going to show you another example to use menu switch or index switch. In this case, let's use, for example, menu switch. Now I want to show different text, different words. So what we can do is to select a string. Remember, you have a lot of options to work with. Now we are going to use a string. A string is the word to use text. However, you cannot connect a string output with geometry. We need to convert this string to a geometry. So we have a node called string to curve. Let's go into here. Now it's taking this string that now we are going to write and convert it to curve. For example, let's add hello. And now we can see here hello, but we need to fill this. So to fill this, let me center this. We need to add a fill curve. So fill curve. And here, when you select menu switch or index switch, you can write whatever you want here. Or just connect this node, where also you can write here whatever you want. It's the same. But now I'm going to leave it here. Hello, how are you? So here I can change between this word and this one. So you can make animations like this one if you add more items below. How we can animate this? Really easy. Just select the first one, click and insert keyframe. And now go forward, click the node to see the keyframes, and just change the option you want. And click to insert another keyframe. So now from here to here we'll say hello, and after that it will say how are you. Let's check it. Hello, how are you? So if you add more options, you can animate any sentence with geometry nodes. So that's all for today. I hope you are learning a lot, and if you want to learn more, I recommend you to give a like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.